Hey everyone, it's Liz over at the Jones Group. I hope you're making it an awesome week. Hey, I've been asked several times during this buyer process of what does it mean to waive the appraisal? How does that affect you? And simply, your home will be evaluated by your lender for value. And they use the last 3 months of purchases to gauge whether or not that house is fairly priced. You're in contract with one number, but the bank says it's worth another number. And how does that affect you when it comes in low? Well, simply, the bank has agreed with terms to you to either support an 80%, so you're putting down 20%, they're putting down 80% of the loan, and they have supported that. Let's say you are 10% down. Well, they have agreed to do 90% of that loan. So when they assess the value of that property, if it happens to come in below the expectations of what you've purchased it for, there is a gap. We call that the appraisal gap. Let's use simple math. So let's say you're buying a home that is a $400,000 home and you are in contract for $400,000 and the bank says, no, it's not worth $400,000, it's worth $350,000. The gap in that place would be $50,000. So you have to find out, can you still afford that house using that appraisal gap? Some people can, some people can't. Let's say you were putting 20% down. Well, you can decide to put only 10% down. That'll bridge the gap some. The bank will loan you 90% of the value that they assessed on it, the 90% of $350,000, and then you move forward with your purchase. There may be some out-of-pocket costs that come your way. So you'll have to make a decision at that point in time whether or not it's well-serving you to move forward. Let's say you absolutely want this house and you're looking at an appraised value of $350,000, you're in contract for four. What are your options? Well, you've got a couple. Option number one is to pay the gap. In other words, pay your seller exactly what you had, and you have to have the money in the bank to support this. Option number two is to drop out of escrow. If you've agreed to waive the appraisal, you can't use the appraisal as your excuse for cancellation. It might be that you can't qualify for the loan anymore, and in this case, you can back out gracefully. Or option number three is to go back to the table and negotiate. So that happens quite often, where the two parties will come together, they realize the value is lower than what you're in contract, nobody likes to lose, so we come up with a win-win solution for everyone. I hope this has been helpful for you. If my team or I can help you in any way, give me a call. My name is Liz Jones with the Jones Group, and until next week, take care. Bye-bye.